What's up, y'all? It's Demacia 9. It's time for another one. So, we have to talk about Tifa because, listen, Final Fantasy Rebirth comes out this week, and we had the leak of Aerith and Tifa on a beach, which a lot of people were happy about, myself included, because it was like, okay, we're getting back to normalcy in regards to these characters. And then we had an update on the Final Fantasy Remake, a four-year-old game. And before I get into my take on this, I want to be perfectly clear. Let's be 100%. While we all love Tifa, you know, she's a fantastic character, she's very powerful, kind, you know, the whole shebang, right? Have a fantastic backstory with Tifa. Tifa is not real. She's pixels. Pixels and sprites, whatever you want to call them, in the digital realm of the internet, right? So, she's not a real person. And when it comes to certain arguments in regards to this particular upgrade, I want to make this perfectly clear. These are the same people who are sitting here saying, oh, you got some kind of a weird thing going on with pixels, are the same people who are okay with the Skittles Nation just spewing their stuff to underage people. Just gonna put that out there. So, what's more important? Pixels or real people? Just gonna put that out there before we get into anything else. Because we got nonsense arguments being put out there about this specific upgrade that makes zero sense. And by the way, it's not just about this particular censorship upgrade. It's been a snowball effect. And like I said, with the leaks of the bikini scenes with Aerith and Tifa, it seems like they were leaning towards probably going back to some kind of common sense. But let's get into this. So here we go. When you look at this here, on this here in Google, so we got the Tifa update. Final Fantasy VII Remake update covers up Tifa's cleavage. So here's the deal. And we're going to go specifically into these actual images in a minute. So this is regards to her Nibelheim flashback, right? And obviously, at that time, Final Fantasy, the mainline story, Tifa's 20, so that would make her 15. So that's where the argument is coming from. Again, here's my question, right? Nobody, this game came out in 1997, the original game. Nobody, and I mean nobody, was worried about Tifa in her younger stage. As a matter of fact, when I played the first played the game the first time in the first game, I didn't really put two and two together because, remember, you, especially because a lot of the translation stuff was kind of a little off in the original one, the way they made the story, I almost thought that it was only a couple years ago when the Nibelheim event happens. Because for Cloud, it technically was, if you're paying attention to the reunion Crisis Core game they put out, which, by the way, that's a lot of the thing that they kind of took this from, the Crisis Core reunion one. But we'll get into that. So, obviously, you got a lot of articles here about that. You know, patches off of Tifa, you know, all the stuff like that. So, I'm not seeing one specifically on the 15-year-old thing, but that was a lot of what people were going in, especially on Twitter, which is irrelevant to me. I really don't care about what those people were saying because, like I said, Tifa's not a real person. If you really want to care about people who are underage, you need to worry about the stuff that's going on with real people. Real people, okay? Not pixels and sprites, okay? Let's squash that, all right? But here's my thing, right? Let's get into this. This is a picture from the original Final Fantasy VII game, 1997. So this was the picture that was taken with Tifa, Sephiroth, and Zack, which in Cloud's mind, he thought it was him, but Cloud was actually there. Spoilers, he was a regular Shinra officer, not a soldier, right? So, this is the actual picture. That's what Tifa looked like. Nobody cared. That's not anything. Everybody adores Tifa in her adult form, right? Granted, again, it's pixels, But that's what people like about Tifa, because she's strong, she's powerful, and of course she's aesthetically pleasing in her adult form. And, you know, call me old-fashioned. I mean, I like to look at Tifa in her adult form, but that's not my thing in real life. You know, I like real people, you know, real females, right? So, that's the original, right? Cool. This is the original Crisis Core. You guys noticing something about that outfit? Right? This is the remake version before the upgrade, which, again, here's my thing. Who on Square Enix's team is the actual real PDF file that was actually looking at this and like, oh my God, I'm feeling some kind of way. We got to cover up. Because that says more about the person who felt that way than the people who are saying, hey, censorship is stupid. And again, I'm going to get to my biggest point because it's not just about this, right? It's not about this. So again, let's just go back real quick. That's the original Final Fantasy VII, 97. This is Crisis Core, the original Crisis Core. This is the remake, okay? All right, this is what happens before the update, and this is the update. Again, it's really not a big deal. I really don't care about the, you know, flashback Tifa. My worry is about as long as Tifa is strong and she can kick some ass. That's what I'm happy about, right? So, there's that. But here's the thing I'm trying to say. See, what a lot of people are forgetting, this all really started from actual censorship. Because guess what? This is the actual design for Tifa back in 97. You see something there that might have been changed, you know, because of, you know, ethics divisions and all that stuff like that? Because that's it started with that, right? Because remember, the remake version was reduced and does have the black top on her, okay? That does the adult version I'm talking about. We're not really worried about the flashback. Obviously, this is another picture of Tifa back in 97. Just saying, you guys see the difference. Now, here's the deal. This is the remake version of her. You see, it's not just, oh, they covered her up in the flashback. No, they've been covering Tifa up the entire time. The entire time they've been covering up. They've been reducing her and covering up because reasons. Again, I don't know who is like, what's the big deal about pixels? But clearly some people have an issue with it. And it ain't me as far as me having a, oh my God, I'm seeing pixels. I hate to tell you, that's not an issue for me. And not for a lot of people, actually. And obviously, here is the new rebirth version, which looks like, again, they're going back to form as far as, you know, leaning more towards the 97. But again, this is still not 97. So, overall, again, it's not really just simply about, oh, they did this thing for the flashback Tifa. No, they've been putting their filthy mitts all over Tifa the whole time. Okay, this has been a whole thing the entire time. Again, overall, doesn't really bother me as long as Tifa's strong, the gameplay's great, and we get some good storylines going on. That's really what it boils down to me with this new game coming out. But let's be real. You guys are doing stuff for reasons that kind of might lean towards the whole ethics division, which is a division that should be thrown out because it's not necessary. Because I don't know. Pixels are not real people. Just saying, because clearly somebody had a problem with it, and it wasn't me with this design of Tifa, okay? It just wasn't. But anyway, overall, listen, like I said, I hope this game is great. I'm looking forward to purchasing it. I'm still playing the remake version on hard, fighting Whis, who's ridiculous, but that's another story. But yeah. How do you feel about this situation with Tifa being, yet again, censored? Because again, it's not just about this one thing, it's about the entire run. Let me know how you feel about that. Like, share, and subscribe. If you want to support the channel, you can hit that super thanks. Remember, you can't be good, be good at it. Peace. Monopoly.